Yeah.
Today in our kitchen, we'll be making a very easy and simple recipe of Raffaello cake. What you guys might also know it for is coconut and almond cake. It's so easy to make and it's absolutely delicious. You're going to see how yummy it looks on the inside and it tastes just like Raffaello's. And trust me, I don't want to say it's just like the bakery because it's even better than that. And the best part about it is made at home. So let's get right into the video. First up, I'm going to take 3 eggs, but only the whites from it. The egg whites are what makes the cake really soft and fluffy. We can also just put the egg straight inside, but just the whites separated from the egg yolk makes it really fluffy and soft. You guys should try it and see there's a huge difference. Hence, I'm separating the egg whites. And now I'm going to beat the egg whites only till it becomes white and fluffy. I'm going to beat it a little bit more. Now I'm going to add in 3/4 cup of sugar. We're going to beat it in the egg white as it's going to make it more fluffier. It's about 2 minutes. It should be looking really fluffy. And there we go. Trust me, this is really going to make the cake really, really soft. Now I'm going to add in 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence into the egg yolks. I'm just going to give it a good mix. And now I'm going to add this into the egg white. I'm just going to gently mix the egg white and the yolks together. You can see how light and fluffy it's already looking. This is indication of a very nice and smooth sponge cake. Next up, I'm adding 1/4 cup oil. You guys can add butter as well, about 150 grams of butter. Now I'm going to add in 1.5 cups of flour as well as 1 teaspoon of baking powder. I'm going to sift the dry ingredients. This is really, really important as the cake will come out really, really smooth if you sift the ingredients. It won't come out gooey. I'm going to gently fold in 1/2 of it. Now I'm going to sift in the rest of the flour and fold that in. You guys can see so far it's so simple and easy. Now I'm going to add in 1/2 cup milk. Lastly, make sure it's at room temperature. Make sure all the ingredients are at room temperature. This is really, really important. Just give it a good mix. Now I'm adding the rest of it. And just fold it in. Now I'm going to add in 1/4 cup almond flour. You guys can take ground almonds as well. This is what's going to give us a really good Raffaello taste. And I'm also going to add 1/3 cup of desiccated coconut. I mean, it's a Raffaello cake, and how can we not add coconut inside? And that's all. Our sponge cake is ready to bake. I've taken a round baking pan. I'm using a non-stick spray. You guys can use butter or flour around it as well. Make sure you bake in a preheated pan. I'm going to bake it at 180 degrees Celsius. And there we go. I'm going to bake it about 20 to 25 minutes or until a toothpick comes out clean. And there we go. It's absolutely ready. You can see the toothpick is coming out clean, and it's so soft because of the egg white. I'm going to let it cool down. So long, I'm going to prepare the frosting for the Raffaello cake. I've taken 1 slab white chocolate and going to melt it. I've taken 500 ml of heavy cream. Make sure it's cold, you just take it out from the refrigerator. And now I'm going to beat it. I know this might take time, but we have to beat it to the right consistency. Give it a good mix. You can see there's still soft peaks. I'm going to beat it a bit more. Now my cream is ready. You can see stiff peaks are being formed. You can see if I tilt the bowl over, it won't fall down. Now I'm going to add in the melted white chocolate. This is going to give us a really nice taste to it. And just mix the white chocolate into the whipping cream. Now I'm going to slice the cake into 2 layers. Firstly, I'm going to remove the top as I want a flat cake. Just carefully slice it. You can see how soft the sponge cake is. And there we go. Now I'm spreading some coconut water. You guys, if you don't have coconut water, you can spread some sugar water as or sugar syrup as well. But we need some kind of liquid, otherwise the cake will just dry out. So I have coconut water. Actually, I have fresh coconut water. And I'm going to spread the whipping cream. I know this can get a bit messy, but that's all about it is. I'm going to add some more. And just spread it all evenly around the cake. You don't have to worry about neatness here because this is just the center layer. It's going to be covered. Now I'm going to cover the top layer with coconut water as well. Now I'm going to add in whipping cream. Just spread it all around the cake. You can add some more in the places you like. And there we go. I've just roughly covered it. Now I've taken fresh coconut, I've grated it. Just going to add it onto the sides of the cake. Just make sure all around it's covered. You guys can take dry coconut as well, but trust me, fresh coconut just gives it a different taste and it's really amazing if you use coconut. Just adding onto the top sides as well. And now some of ground almonds on the side. This is how I like to decorate my Raffaello cake. You guys can decorate it however you like. And let's not forget the Raffaello's on top. This is just like the cherry on top of our cake. You can see how delicious it's looking. It's looking almost perfect. You wouldn't guess you made it at home. I'm just adding white arrow chocolate as well. It's totally optional. There we go. It's looking perfect. You guys can see this was a really easy and simple recipe to make. And you can see the cake is looking delicious. And I can also smell the coconut, the fresh coconut from here. Please do like, share and subscribe.